Okay, well, first of all, again, appreciate you guys coming today. Today is the end of a lot of hard work before we head into the next phase of recruiting. We signed 15 players between the early signing period and today. We're very excited about each and every one of them. They all come highly recommended. We filled a lot of needs that we had. I think that every guy that we signed will have a tremendous opportunity to come in here and help us right away. So we're excited about that. And, you know, one thing when you kind of get to this end of the recruiting period, there's a lot of people that you got to thank that did put a lot of hours in to help make this thing happen. But I say it every year, Samford sells itself. We have a great university, great professors. Academically, we're second to none. Football-wise, you know, we're coming off back-to-back playoff seasons for the first time in 25 years. Here at Samford, so we're headed in the right direction, and we've developed a great culture here. We feel like each and every one of these young men we just signed will fit in just fine, and hopefully help us to win one more game next year. If we do that, we'd be the conference champ. So we're looking forward to seeing what these guys do when they come put the Samford Bulldog uniform on next fall.
Just based on the list that you have here, it seemed like defensive front was a big priority for you guys. Is that right?
It is. It is every year. You know, one thing about it, we go into each season with kind of a marker of how many we want to get at each position due to attrition from the year before. But we never turn down good defensive linemen. That's where you win. That's why we've been so successful. But we needed to get some young guys to come in. We took a big hit there last year. We have some guys that are key players this upcoming year that'll be seniors. So we needed these young guys to come in and get their feet wet early on. So we were really pleased with the guys that we were able to sign.
2/3 from the state of Alabama and Georgia, 10 out of 15. Has it always been that way, or has it just kind of fall randomly?
Well, you know, one thing about it, and again, it's something I say every year, you know, we start here at the gates of Samford University and work our way out and try to find the best players that we can get that fit the mission we have here. And naturally, Alabama plays tremendous football. Georgia plays tremendous football. Florida plays tremendous football. Mississippi, Tennessee have great players. And that's just our main blueprint. So, you know, wherever they come from, if we feel like they fit our mission, we're going to try to go get them. But naturally, you like to stay as close to home as possible if you can.
Now that the process is over, a lot of coaches don't have good things to say about the early signing period. I remember in December, you didn't have too many bad things to say, though. So now that the process is complete, just what's your impression of, you know, the two parts?
It's awesome. It was great. And, you know, I don't delve into the rules too much. I just, you know, hey, whatever y'all tell me to do is what we're going to do. But I thought it was great. I really think that next year, and just in my limited personal opinion, that more players will sign early on. But, you know, it was really good for us. It let us focus on a couple of the needs that we had that we didn't sign early here in January. Also, it gave us a springboard to start really delving into the 2019 prospects, because this operation just keeps speeding up the more years that I'm in the coaching profession. So, you know, I would be hard pressed that if you could find too many coaches that didn't see some merit in the early signing period.
Familiar name on that list, Ty Hatcher. It's got to be kind of special for you as a dad and as a coach to sign him.
Well, it was awesome to see him be able to you know, sign today at Samford. You know, I've coached him in Little League, but you know, I'm really a good parent. I sit far away as I can from the action. I let him play, and you know, I let him make his own decisions about his future. But you know, we think he's a really good player. And with an unbiased opinion, you know, but as a dad, he's a really good boy and a great son. So it'll be a lot of fun getting to coach him. I think it will. We're excited at our household that, you know, he'll be close to mama. But he has a lot of good friends on the team. And, you know, and it goes to say a lot about the football players that we have. They've treated him very well since he's been here. So he's like family, and we get to see him suit up in the fall. And I'm excited about having him on our football team.